Welcome to my YouTube channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy. In this video, we will talk about the pharmacological actions of the parasympathomimetics. Cholinergic agonists show actions like that of parasympathetic stimulation, and these are divided into two groups. That is, directly acting agents and indirectly acting agents, as we discussed in the previous video. These two groups have similar actions but not always identical to each other. So let's talk about the pharmacological actions associated with the direct acting drugs first, and in the second video we will discuss about the indirect acting agents' pharmacological actions. Direct acting drugs show their effects by binding to cholinoceptors found on different organs of our body. These include the cardiovascular system, respiratory system, eyes, GI tract, urinary bladder, glands, and nervous system. The effects on the cardiovascular system are like that of vagal stimulation. And first, let's discuss about the heart. Effects of cholinomimetic agents on the heart include cardiac slowing or negative chronotrophic effect leading to bradycardia and decrease in cardiac output or negative ionotropic effect. The decrease in heart rate is due to the hyperpolarization of the sinoatrial nodal cells and the decrease in their rate of diastolic depolarization, while the decrease in cardiac output action is mainly due to a decreased force of contraction of the atria, because the ventricles have only a weak parasympathetic innervation and a low sensitivity to muscarinic agonists. The cholinoceptors responsible for cardiac effects are M2 cholinoceptors. Furthermore, the effects of parasympathomimetics on the heart are often opposed by reflex sympathetic activation and response to low blood pressure. Reflex tachycardia occurs due to the release of catecholamines by sympathetic neurons. Therefore, net cardiac effects depend on the local concentration of agonists in the heart. While acting on the blood vessels of the cardiovascular system, parasympathomimetic direct acting agents dilate blood vessels. This vasodilation is primarily mediated through the release of endothelium-dependent relaxing factor, which is nitric oxide, while few are dilated directly through receptor activations. The receptors involved in vasodilation are the M3 cholinoceptors. So, the overall effect of parasympathomimetics on the cardiovascular system is the decrease in blood pressure. Then we have the respiratory tract. Well, the respiratory tract also responds to parasympathomimetics, and the effects of direct acting cholinomimetics include the contraction of bronchial smooth muscles and stimulation of the secretion of tracheobronchial glands. These effects cause the airways of the lungs to become narrow. Next, we have GI tract, and the effects of direct acting parasympathomimetics on the GI tract are diverse. These agents increase the secretory activity of the digestive glands like salivary, gastric, pancreatic, and small intestinal glands. And secondly, the peristaltic movement increased throughout the GI tract, while most of the sphincters relax in response to these agents. After this, we have the urinary tract. The main target of cholinergic agonists in the urinary system is the bladder. Muscarinic agonists stimulate the detrusor muscle and relax the trigonal and sphincter muscles of the bladder, and thus promote the voiding of urine. Then we have the eyes to discuss here. Cholinergic agonists in the eye cause contraction of the iris sphincter muscles, causing miosis, and contraction of ciliary muscle causes the accommodation of lenses for near vision. Both effects decrease the intraocular pressure. Furthermore, cholinergic drugs influence the activity of several glands discussed above and other glands by increasing their secretions, like that of lacrimal glands, nasopharyngeal glands, and sweat glands. After this, we have the central nervous system effects of cholinomimetics here. The cholinomimetic agents, which can cross the blood-brain barrier, will have central nervous system effects. And those drugs generally first stimulate and then cause depression of the CNS. But basically, action on the central nervous system varies from drug to drug. For example, nicotine causes mild alerting action, while at higher doses, nicotine causes vomiting, tremor, and respiratory center stimulation. While at very higher doses, nicotine is responsible for effects like convulsion and coma. After this, the effects of cholinomimetics on the peripheral nervous system are different from that of the central nervous system effects, because the peripheral effects of the cholinomimetics are due to the stimulation of nicotinic receptors mainly, while the CNS effects are contributed by both muscarinic as well as nicotinic receptors. So the drugs with nicotinic properties will have a great impact on the peripheral nervous system, and these nicotinic agonists will cause marked activation of autonomic ganglia and simultaneously the discharge of both sympathetic as well as parasympathetic nervous system. And thus, different organs respond differently depending upon the sensitivity of these organs to the sympathetic and parasympathetic innervations. For example, the action of nicotinic agonists on the cardiovascular system is mostly sympathomimetic, that include hypertension and tachycardia. The sympathetic tachycardia may alternate with vagal discharge-induced bradycardia. While in contrast to it, in GI and urinary tracts, the effects are largely parasympathomimetic, that include nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and voiding of urine. But here, prolonged exposure of the ganglia to nicotinic agonists may result in depolarizing blockade, as we discussed in the previous video on the cholinergic agonists. Another site of cholinomimetic drugs is neuromuscular junctions. The nicotinic receptors are involved, and upon stimulation cause immediate depolarization of postsynaptic end plate, resulting in strong muscular contraction. Same as the above, the prolonged exposure causes depolarizing blockade, leading to placid paralysis in the case of skeletal muscles. The pharmacological actions of parasympathomimetics on the peripheral organs are mainly due to the muscarinic receptors activation, and these are considered as muscarinic actions. While the actions on the peripheral neurons and neuromuscular junctions are termed as nicotinic actions, while the actions on CNS are considered mixed functions of both nicotinic and muscarinic origin. And with this, thanks for watching. Do like and share this video and support us by subscribing to our channel.